starting off the video with getting 90 runecrafting, and this is actually pretty huge because this allows me to use another type of pouch, and it is going to speed up my experience by quite a bit. And I only need to get 2 more ethereal pieces as well, and then I have the full set, which is also going to allow me to bring more pure essence. Also, now that I got my dragons breeding, I managed to settle some of them for a lot of beans, and I haven't bought the trapper yet. I don't know why, but I just forgot about it, so I'm going to do that right now. And I'm not sure exactly where he is. Oh, there he is. So it only costs 100 beans to send him away. And then after that, he's going to try to find an unchecked animal, and it should take 6 hours. And then it's going to be back and give me a random one. You can get really lucky and get some super good, like, dragons, I think, are the best. And you can get the Raksha thing as well, I think. And you can get shiny animals as well. You can get some really good stuff. But most of the time, it's probably pretty mediocre, but it's still only 100 beans, so it's definitely worth doing. So now with the infinitely charged massive pouch, because I have the relic of course, I get, instead of 2,700 experience every craft, I get up to 3,300. So what is that, like 600 more every round, as well as when I do get my ethereal set, which I only miss one piece for, I will get even more than that, so probably around 3,500. I always struggle to get soul runes on my account, and I can't craft them because you need to have done this quest, Fight Club. And for that, there is actually a lot of quest requirements. So first off, I have to do Our Man in the North, and then I have to do No Evil and Crocodile Tears. These quests themselves have quite some quest requirements I have to do. Crocodile Tears I need to have, Dealing with Scarabs as well, Bring Leela to the Sentinel Tomb, and also I have already rank 3 in all Manifold's Reputations, but I think it might be worth unlocking this. Soul Runes is pretty good crafting experience, as well as having a lot of them is going to enable me to use this ability a lot while PVMing, Incite Fear, and it is very strong for Slayer cleaving, and also very good for if you do get the Staff of Armadil. It actually scales really well off of it if you get the crit and lower adrenaline cost on your Tsunami. It actually makes the staff super strong. I don't have it, of course, but overall having soul runes is just nice to be able to have on my account. So I'm going to be working towards this quest. So I've now done all the quests that is on screen right now, and I have all the requirements to do the Fight Club quest. If I go down here, we can check the requirements. There is only one thing I have to do: achieve rank 9 overall Manifold's Reputation, and that actually takes quite a while. But I'm going to probably do it through shifting tombs and the daily pillars or whatever they're called. There's you can join a friend chat and you get like 20,000 reputation every day for free, basically. But before I do that, I am going to actually get 90 construction, which is now 90 base, I'm pretty sure. I think that is 90 in all stats at least. Yes, there is the pop-up. And the reason why is because in shifting tombs, if you have 90 construction, 90 runecrafting, and 90 in like a bunch of different skills, which I now have as I have base 90s, you get more rewards, and I will need that for the grind, as well as just getting more agility experience that I'm going to be putting on the shifting tombs is very nice meanwhile doing the grind. I am currently pretty close to rank 7, I think, so I have to grind for quite a while, and of course in the minigame you open chests, and it has a 1 in 800 chance of giving you a Kopesh, the offhand version. If I would get that, that would be pretty interesting, but yeah, you can see here I am tier 6, but pretty close to tier 7. So before, when I was doing tier 3 shifting tombs, I was getting like 800, maybe 750 reputation per run, and it is dependent on what objectives you get, but I think this is a pretty average 132, and I get 1032, and of course also almost 5000 agility experience, and now and then you get these offerings that you can trade in for reputation. This one is 350. So it is actually almost doubled, 612, because I've done the quests that increase my reputation gain. I was just AFKing some fishing for Manifold's Reputation in the VIP area, and I got this pet. I don't think it's that rare. I think it's like 1 in 1k to 1 in 3k when catching different type of fish. But yeah, it is required for an achievement. And also, I got the Desert Pantheon aura, which you can't use some of the options on an Ironman, for example, the experience boosts, but the 10% reputation gained with the Menophos for an hour is really nice. And I have currently zero charge, but tomorrow I will be able to use this aura, and for future use it is pretty good to have. Finally, we are now tier 9 on the Menophos reputation, and I can complete the Fight Club quest. You can see that in the chat right there. I actually turned out to do mostly soul obelisks. I did it for 2 days, and I used the Desert Pantheon aura on the second day for 10% more reputation. You can see it right there. And I can use that twice a day because it gains 250 charge and it costs 125 to use it. So that is pretty nice. Can use when I want to grind this up even higher in the future. But right now it is time for the Fight Club quest. Look at that. That is the Soul Altar, which I'm basically unlocking now. This is the end of the quest, but there is some dialogue first, of course. It is pretty nice, the Soul Altar, because it makes runecrafting fairly AFK. I will show you guys after this clip. But also, I think I get like, 8,000 reputation or something like that with any faction of the Menophos area. But 200% more reputation as well, so getting that last step to tier 10 is going to be a bit faster. But also, here you can see access to the Soul Altar. And let's actually go and hand this in first. Oh my god, it's 15,000. Is it 15,000 base or 15,000 after the 200%? Let's see. Yes. Oh, it's 15,000 after the buff. But yeah, that is a lot of reputation gained. But let's check out the Soul Altar now. As a matter of fact, I tried to enter, and you can't actually enter before you've unlocked the altar itself. So you have to actually enter it once normally to be able to go through the abyss to open it. And you need a soul talisman for that, which I don't have. And the only way of getting it is either through shifting tombs, which is 1 in 200, which I am not doing. That is going to be very time consuming. Or you can kill some Ankh creatures that has a 1 in 200 drop rate of them as well. The feline Ankh, or Ak, I don't know how to pronounce it. But they, as I said, have a drop rate of 1 in 200, so that should not be too bad. That did not take that long. Soul Talisman, probably like 50 kills or something like that. So now let's try out the Soul Altar. This altar works a lot different than the other ones, so I have all my purisms now and I deposit them, it takes all of them, and then after that I have to click charge altar, which takes quite a while, so I'll be back in just a bit. So basically how it works is that I think 5 purisms is 1 charge and 1 charge is 1 soul rune, so basically making 1 soul rune is 5 purisms, so I will need a lot of purisms for this method. And you can actually charge up to 100 soul runes, and that was only 22. So I could technically just go to a bank and then come back with even more purisms all the way until 100. But I'm just going to click this now for 22 for one inventory and see the experience. So that's craft. It's instant and it's 21,000 experience for one click. So if I would run back and forth like 4 times, that would be, I would assume, 81,000 experience or 80-something thousand experience for one press. And 18 soul runes only, that is very minor. I don't think I can click again. Yeah, that's all the charges I had. But I'm actually going to charge it up a bit more now. I'm going to go to Edgeville again and I'm going to try to see... Where's my wilderness sword? There we go. I'm going to charge this and charge it as much as you possibly can and see the experience drop. As I only have like 2,000 purisms left in my bank, I was looking into ways to get more purisms and I was leaning towards abyssal demons. But then I found out, I don't think I've opened this before, there is a chest that you get access to one time after the Rune Mysteries quest that gives you purisms based on your runecrafting level, and I am 90 now. So this should give me a lot of purisms. Let's see, 20,475 purisms. That is a lot of purisms. Oh, I don't even know. Will that last me to 99? If it does, that is actually so nice. Alright, so I've now stored as much as possible. You can see in the chat, 100 charges. And let's craft now and see the experience. Also, I'm at 28 urns. I assume it's going to take more than one urn this craft. So let's see. all the way to 17 and I get 93,000 runecrafting experience from one press. Did you see how many rune urns that was? That was like 12 urns in total from one press. Oh my god, I completely forgot about this. I'm going to pick up what I get. Let's see what animal I get. Please, dragon would be nice. Rooster? Are you kidding me? A rooster? Isn't that like a normal thing that you buy for like 10 beans or something? Billy, a male, alright. I'll send him out again. Please don't give me a rooster again. As you might see on my skills, I've been doing a lot of runecrafting. I'm now 95, but I'm going to stop for now. I've got 3.2 million runecrafting experience, and of course, getting 99 with soul runecrafting is actually very chill. So in the next video, I'm going to finish that off. But for the last part of this video, I want to get some Raksha kills done. And at least I'll do 5 or something like that, so we double our KC. Oh! What? What? Divert ability codex? I think that's one of the worst ones, but I think it's actually as rare as a ricochet. Oh my... what's my KC even? Where is it? Solo mode. 6 KC and I get a divert ability codex. And sirenic scales as well. That is very nice. How much is it worth? 17 mil. So yeah, it's definitely one of the worst ones, but hey, that's not complaining. Imagine the back-to-back. No, okay. Well, 1.1 million in Alex is definitely not bad for an Ironman, and I'm running low on money as well, so that's pretty nice. I can see the 10k, what is it actually? And that was a record kill as well, Black Dragonite. I think you get a lot of these. Second to last kill, actually had 42 corruption here, so pretty bad. For Stone Spirits, I guess I kind of deserved that with 42%. And the last kill is going to be some crystal keys. Okay. So that is now 10 KC done, and of course, and now I'm getting kills pretty consistently. I die now and then or have to teleport out, but most of the time I do manage to get the kill, so that is very nice. So with that, I am going to end the video here. I think my Pernix boots are not having a great time, 22% charge. Also, my Sirenic mask is 6%. How much invention charge do I even have? 4 hours left, that's not too bad. But yeah, I've got some stuff to restock on, as well as I want to get that 99 runecrafting done. I don't think I can actually teleport to my farm and get another one of those animals collected. But we can have a look. Maybe he's back. Oh, he is back. All right, then I guess this is going to be the end of the video when I collect this. And hopefully we don't get a rooster again. That would be pretty unfortunate. But we do get... Oh my... Wait, that's actually perfect. You guys might not know this, but I actually don't have a red Chinchompa, and they are required to make mechanized Chinchompas. What a good way to end the video. Look at that. Tiddles, male child. I guess I'm putting it into this one. And yeah, that is the end of this video. Look at him. I just can't end the video. Look at this. I have to show this. Surly. Oh, fewer beans. I don't care about that. But yeah, that's it for this video. Hope you guys did enjoy it. Have a good one, guys. Like the video and all that good stuff. Bye.